you can implement network-secured global ingress with Azure Front Door Premium tier. Network Secure Ingress is a meta pattern that encapsulates several patterns, including the gateway routing and gateway offloading patterns. An implementation with Azure Front Door Premium tier supports the following aspects of Network Secure Global Ingress: global routing to workloads in different regions, low latency failover for unhealthy workloads, and mitigating attacks at the edge. For this scenario, we have deployed Azure Blob storage accounts in East US and West US 3. Each storage account has a container named web that contains an index.html page that indicates whether it is from East or West. These will simulate our regional static workloads. We deployed Azure Front Door Premium tier. The storage accounts were configured as origins or backends. Private link was enabled for each origin, and a global WAF policy with managed rules was associated to our front door instance. Let's look at it in the portal. Here are the two storage accounts. They're locked down from a network perspective. We have public network access set to selected networks and IP addresses and haven't added any VNets or IP addresses. You can see that we are not able to access them from the browser. Here is our front door premium tier deployment. You can see the endpoint that will be exposed to our consumer. Our endpoint has one route configured that routes traffic to our origin group. The web origin group has origins set up for our east and west storage accounts. We will look at those in a moment. We have configured a health probe to the path to our index.html page. In the real world, you would likely have the path point to a health endpoint that properly determines the health of an origin, but pointing to the static page will work for our demo. This configuration will deem an origin healthy if 3 out of the last 4 probes are successful. Traffic will only be routed to healthy origins. Our east origin points to our east storage account. The important thing to notice here is that enable private link service is checked. You will note the request message. Azure Front Door is requesting private link access to the resource, the storage account in our case. The request will have to be approved in that resource. Once approved, Azure Front Door will be able to securely access the storage account over the Microsoft Backbone network. Here, you can see where you approve the private link request in the storage account. Here is the message. The last configuration setting we are concerned with here are the security policies. We created a global WAF policy with managed rules with prevention set. In the demo, we will illustrate the SQL injection rule. We'll test the configurations by navigating to the front door endpoint in the browser. You can see that we are indeed routing between the two regions. That was our first goal, global routing. To show that the health probes work, we need to simulate a failure. We'll simulate this by making the East storage account not publicly accessible. As you can see, it is not able to access the content in the East origin. After a minute or two, the probes have determined that the East origin is unhealthy. You can see that we are no longer routing traffic to the east. Let's reset the public access to anonymous and wait for the probes to deem the endpoint healthy. We are again routing to the east. That was our second goal, low latency failover for unhealthy workloads. The last thing to show is how we are mitigating attacks at the edge. We'll enter a nefarious query string, simulating a SQL injection attack. You can see that the request was blocked. That was our third goal, mitigating attacks at the edge. The storage accounts are only accessible through front door, and our WAF policy is mitigating attacks. By using Azure Front Door Premium tier, you can route global traffic to only healthy workloads while mitigating attacks at the edge.